here to celebrate Kate and Thomas, right? But before it was Kate and Thomas, it was just my best friend, Kate. When she first started mentioning a hometown Harlingen guy that she had a crush on, and spoiler alert, it was Thomas. We did what anyone else would do, right? And we were absolutely hyping her up.
Thomas, I gotta tell you, when you and Kate first started dating, how long ago?
Oh, 7 years ago, 7 years.
Seven, lucky seven. I talked to my boys, Frank and Kyle. I said, all right, guys, tell me about this Thomas kid. And they said, oh, Dad, he's cool. He's a good kid. So you got the broquet really early on.
As long as I've known Thomas, he's always had people around him who loved him and cherished him. When we first met, I gave him a really hard time because it seemed he'd gone to college with all of his childhood best friends. But what I didn't appreciate at the time was the most important person in his life was still back home.
Kate, she's compassionate, she's loving, she's caring, and she's just been a really great friend to me over the years. While we were at college, we would come and visit Thomas and some of our other friends here in Austin, and at some point Kate came along with us, and it's crazy to think that those small trips to Austin somewhat contributed to us being here tonight.
Let me know I trust you so. Looking at you through the lights, circle blinking in the tungsten, wondering how I seem to you, forgetting the words I'm singing for you. Am I forgetting that?
Thomas has always been notorious for breaking things, whether it's an arm or a wine glass. I was definitely the one at fault with this story. But when Thomas and I were young, I was over at the Boswell's house for a play day. I guess we just watched the fighting scene on TV and we felt the need that we needed to go reenact it. So we go upstairs to Thomas's room. We're exchanging some karate kicks back and forth. Got a little aggressive. I finally put some more power behind my kick. Knocked Thomas backwards, lost his balance, and he fell back and hit his head on the staircase and cracked his head open. My first instinct was to run downstairs to the Boswells, and according to them, the first words out of my mouth was, Thomas has a head problem. So I honestly don't remember much after that. I think I was sent home because of my actions. Although Thomas was always breaking things, whether it's his fault or not, I know one thing that is unbreakable, even for Thomas, and that is his love for Kate. Kate, I've known you for a long time too. You've always been so kind, fun, and genuine to everyone. But most importantly, you bring out the best in Thomas. I think we all found out a long time ago, but I'm glad that Thomas found the best friend in you.
When I think on my past, I see I loved you many years before you came. In my homes and my dreams, with the wives and the moon away. Oh, you know me well, and know me well, know me well.
We're so happy to have you as part of our family, Kate. You're the light of Thomas's life. You're a light in our family's life. And we're delighted to have you, even though you're an Aggie.
Really strongly about who was going to get married and when and why, and a bet was formed. Whoever correctly guessed the person to get married, the rest would buy him a drink. Well, naturally, I gravitated towards Thomas. He and I were sharing a dorm room, and I knew from that experience that he was extremely patient and easy to live with. I also knew that he was unafraid to be himself. After all, he was breaking out his acoustic guitar and serenading anyone he could, despite us making fun of him mercilessly for it.
There are so many qualities of a friend that I cherish about you, but the one that I cherish the most about you is how present you are. You saved me from a freeze with no power from our yearly Austin freeze. You're my Valentine's date when I didn't have one. Helped me work through breakups, being ghosted, and now cheered on from the moment I met my person.
Being friends with Kate is honestly just the best. She gives others her all without ever expecting anything in return. She is ambitious and so, so talented, but she's always humble. And best of all, she is ceaselessly kind. Every day, I'm honored and just in awe of everything that she does.
Once I get this feeling, then I see you. Girl, I need it. Ooh, baby. Well, I can't wait much longer. It's getting stronger. Baby, I need it right now. Oh, yeah.
You're setting out on your own together, but you are not alone. It is not the two of you just romantically standing against the world. You've wisely gathered your families, your friends, lots and lots of friends. You're beginning this wild and improbable life together, this adventure, deliberately. And you're desiring God's presence and seeking His blessing and His grace, not just this evening, but each day of your life. Now that Kate and Thomas have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. If you sing along, till I remember. Mark this kneeling in the simplest.